Okay, so in last class, I have discussed about the feeding of calves, calf starter ration, how we can prepare the calf starter ration, what ingredients we have to use for formulation of calf starter ration, and feeding of different stage of cattle and buffalo. We have discussed about the compound cattle feed in last class. And in continuation of this, today I will discuss about the thumbs rule of feeding of cattle and buffalo, as well as the scientific feeding of cattle and buffalo. So thumbs rule is basically it is based on the experience of the farmers and livestock owners, and according to experience, they are feeding their cattle and buffalo, and whatever livestock they have, in case of goat, sheep also. So based on the experience, they are feeding, and they know about the what kind of the feed and how much amount of the feed which is being required for the animals they have. So accordingly they feed, and this method is well practiced in village level, but it is not suitable for the commercial animals rearing practices, because the commercial animal rearing practices which needs scientific feeding for getting optimum production from that particular animals, because in commercial feeding practices, the economy is well linked with the animals and farmers' wellness. So small things which affect the production level of the animal, and ultimately they affect the economy of the farmers. So scientific feeding is very much important to feed the livestock or animals which are of medium and high producing animals. So there are generally three types of the ration we have to formulate for feeding of the animals: for maintenance ration, gestation ration, and production ration. In last class, I have discussed in detail about that also. So what is the maintenance ration? Maintenance ration is the minimum amount of feed which is being required to maintain the essential body process at their optimum rate without any gain in body weight or loss in body weight, or there is no change in the body composition as well. So this is called maintenance ration. So when we prepare the maintenance ration, we should think about this, and after that we can offer the production ration. So before offering the production ration or gestation ration, that means the pregnancy period ration, first we offer the maintenance ration, then we can add the amount of the ingredients, and we can add the amount of the nutrients, whatever the fulfill according to the life cycle of the animals. So we can add on ration after the maintenance. First we offer maintenance, then add-on ration will be given to gestation period and production level. Production level, again, it depends on the different production cycle, like in case of the growth, that means growing animals, they need more amount of more protein for getting optimum growth. And in case of the lactating animal, for fulfill the nutrient requirement for the milk production, as well as in case of the sheep for wool production. So accordingly we can prepare, and it depends on the production efficiency of the animal. So nutrient requirement will depend on the production efficiency of the animal, how much animals they are produce. It also vary with the size, that means body weight of the animals, breeds of the animals, environmental condition where we can rear the animals. So these are the factors which also associated with the offering the different ration and affect the nutrient availability and nutrient requirement of animals under different phases of the life of the livestock. So under these circumstances, the compound which the concentrated mixture which have at least 20% of crude protein, or when we talk about in terms of the protein, in terms of the digestible crude protein, that is DCP, then it should be around 14% to 16%, and it should have also 68% to 72% minimum requirement of the TDN, that is the total digestible nutrient, which is the measurement unit of the energy in ration formation. And it should be, the ration should be well palatable, and palatability should be good, and it should have the laxative action as well. So to avoid any GI tract disturbance, and variety of the feeds which should be included, number of the ingredients should be more in the ration, then it will be well balanced ration, and most of the nutrient which is available in that ration, whatever required. So for preparation of the balanced feed, variety and number of the ingredients should be more. It is always better. And it should have contain, the ration should have, must have minerals and vitamin supplements as well. So different minerals, you are aware about that, major minerals and minor or micro minerals, micro and micro minerals. So these mineral balances, as well as the vitamins, whatever required, generally fat soluble vitamins are required, essentially required for the ruminant species. So these are, when prepare the ration, we should think about that, and we should include it in the ration when preparation of the concentrated feed in optimum amount, whatever required, not in excess concentration, but it should be in optimum. So the amount of the concentrate mixture and straw, that means roughage and concentrate. For adult dairy cattle, you can see the examples here. This much is required. But before that, I have to discuss about the roughage and concentrate ratio. What should be the roughage and concentrate ratio? Actually, for maintenance in case of growing stage, if animal is in growing stage, then we can offer at least 50-50 ratio, 50% roughage and 50% concentrate we can offer. If animal is in production stage, that means the animal producing milk, and optimum quantity of milk they are producing, then we can suggest either the ratio is 40% roughage and 60% concentrate. And if animal is high produce condition, animal produces more than 15 or 20 liter milk, then we can offer the roughage concentrate to, roughage should be 30% and concentrate should be 70%. So accordingly, if animal is less producing and in dry condition, then we can offer only 60% roughage and 40% concentrate. Even we can reduce the concentrate, even 30% concentrate and 70% roughages we can offer. It depends on the stage of the animal, and it depends on the breeds and types of the animals, whether it is JU cattle, whether it is crossbreed cattle, whether it is foreign breed or exotic breeds. So it depends on the ratio of the roughage and concentrate. It depends on the types of the animal, life cycle of the animal, a stage of production, and it depends on the breeds of the animals. So accordingly, we can choose and select, and we can opt the roughage concentrate ratio and feed to the animals. Here just example that you can suggest that for adult dairy cattle, you can offer 4 to 6 kg straw and concentrate mixture 1 to 2 kg. That means 5 kg straw and 1.5 kg concentrate mixture, along with you have to offer 15 to 20 kg green fodder. So that will fulfill the requirement of the animals. But in generally the farmers in villages, the poor farmers, they feed 6 kg straw and 1 kg whatever the concentrate available. That means single ingredients they can feed, like either maize is available in his home, or wheat is available, or any kitchen material is available, kitchen garbage materials, any oil cakes is available. So whatever available, they are not preparing as a mixture. They just feed to the animals whatever available in the. So these practices should reduce the production, and farmers cannot get optimum production according to the whatever the breed and the efficiency of the production of the animals. So this idea is and the knowledge, lacking of the knowledge, affect the production of the animals and affect the whole life cycle as well, life cycle of the animal, because the lack of nutrient is and deficiency of the vital nutrient is always is being noticed in that particular case. So we should promote the feeding of the balance ration always to livestock according to their life cycle. In case of the gestation ration or pregnancy, under the pregnancy period, from the 5th month onward, the nutrient requirement is enhanced to maintain the optimum growth of the fetus, because the in last trimester of the pregnancy, the fetal growth is higher side. So to maintain the growth of the fetus, as well as the maintain the nutrient requirement of the mother, and to get optimum production of the milk from that particular animals, we should enhance the nutrient requirement. And how we can enhance the nutrient requirement? We should add on the ration, add on the concentrate feed. So we should add accordingly as per the requirements. So we can add around just double the concentrate. Then under the maintenance ration, we are feeding 1.5 kg. Then we can add 2 kg more concentrate. We can constant the straw feeding, but we can increase the grain fodders accordingly during that condition. So in case of the production ration, actually in production ration, there is additional requirement of the nutrient which required for getting optimum production of the milk in whole production, whole lactation cycle. That means we should offer the maintenance requirement, then add on the production ration accordingly. So you are aware about that for every kg or every 2 kg of the milk, in case of buffalo, every 2 kg of the milk, we should offer 1 kg concentrate extra from the maintenance. And for every 2.5 kg of the milk, we should offer 1 kg concentrate extra after maintenance. So accordingly, we can increase the concentrate ration or concentrate feed in add-on in case of the production ration according to the milk production. So this is a thumbs rule. We cannot calculate everything here, and we cannot calculate the body weight here. So this practice is being followed in village level, and they followed by the most of the farmers. But when we compute, or we can formulate the ration for cattle and buffalo, and so we should keep in mind that how we can calculate the optimum requirement of that particular animals, and what amount of the nutrient is being required for that particular animals, how much concentrate is required, how much roughage is required, how much cream powder is required. So in scientific feeding, we must calculate the dry matter requirement. So first point is, first point of consideration is requirement, dry matter requirement of the particular animals. So when we formulate the ration for our total mixed ration or requirement, when we calculate the requirement of the animals, first point to consider is dry matter requirement. So dry matter requirement kitna hona chahiye, kitna khilana chahiye animal ko, that means dry matter requirement kya hoga us animal ka. Jab scientific formulation ki baat, scientific ration, scientific feeding ki baat karenge, to sabse pehla point to consider karenge wo dry matter requirement kya hona chahiye. Uske baad consider karenge protein requirement, protein kitna hona chahiye us ration mein jo hum us particular animal ko feed karenge. So what is the requirement of the protein? That means in terms of digestible protein, crude protein. उसके बाद एनर्जी का रिक्वायरमेंट कितना होना चाहिए इन टर्म्स ऑफ टोटल डाइजेस्टिबल न्यूट्रिएंट. सो थ्री बेसिक थिंग्स वी हैव टू केप्ट रिमेंबर ऑलवेज व्हेन वी फॉर्मुलेटिंग द रेशन फॉर एनी एनिमल्स. सो फॉर दैट वी हैव टू नो द बॉडी वेट ऑफ द एनिमल. फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द ड्राई मैटर वी शुड नो द बॉडी वेट ऑफ द एनिमल फर्स्ट. So how we can calculate the dry matter requirement? It is well known fact that to know the dry matter requirement of the particular animal, we should know the body weight of the animal. So we should measure or we should weigh the animals first. And after weighing, we know the body weight of the animal, how much body weight. And it is a standard value that cattle, in case of the cattle, which generally consumes per day 2 to 2.5 kg dry matter. Dry matter means dry source of the feed, which does not contains the, any moisture. So dry feed per cattle requires per day 2 to 2.5 kg for every 100 kg body weight. That means 2 to 2.5% of the body weight, we can say. Dry matter is required 2 to 2.5% of the body weight in case of cattle. However, in case of buffalo and crossbreed animals, crossbreed cattle or exotic cattle, we can offer 2.5 to 3 kg. The requirement is slightly higher in case of buffalo and crossbreed cattle. So it varies from 2.5 to 3 kg per 100 kg body weight or 2.5 to 3% of the body weight. So you must remember this value in case of the Jebu cattle. The dry matter requirement is 2 to 2.5% of the body weight. In case of buffalo and crossbreed cattle, the dry matter requirement is 2.5 to 3% of the body weight. So accordingly, how much amount of the roughage and concentrate will be required? So we can calculate. I will show the examples of 400 kg body weight cattle, how much dry matter is required, total dry matter requirement. So accordingly, total dry matter will be calculated. So here you can see that the total dry matter in case of the concentrate, we should select 1/3 of the concentrate. The ration should have 1/3 concentrate and 2/3 roughage. And 2/3 roughage again divided into 2/3 of dry roughage. The source, the roughage source is dry roughage and green roughage. So roughage mein 2/3 dry roughage hona chahiye aur 1/3 green roughage hona chahiye. Lekin agar leguminous fodder available hai, then we can reduce the dry roughage. We can enhance the dry roughage concentration. Accordingly, we can take 3/4 leguminous fodder and 1/4 leguminous. If we can take 1/3 of the green roughage portion, then we can take 1/4 of the leguminous. So here you can see that the examples how we can calculate it in case of the crossbreed cow. So crossbreed cow having 400 kg body weight, जनरली जेवू कैटल 300 250 300 350 से ज्यादा नहीं होता है उसका बॉडी वेट, बहुत अच्छा होगा तो 300 325 kg बॉडी वेट। बट इन केस ऑफ क्रॉस ब्रीड कैटल दे हैव इन जनरल 350 से 400 kg 450 kg बॉडी वेट तक हो सकता है। सो इन बिटवीन द क्रॉस ब्रीड काउ हैविंग बॉडी वेट 400 kg, दिस इज वन एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द ड्राइंग मैटर, हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट। यू कैन सी दिस टेबल द टोटल ड्राइंग मैटर रिक्वायरमेंट, इफ बॉडी वेट इज ऑफ 400 kg देन the total dry requirement dry matter requirement is for 10 kg. 10 kg dry matter will be required for body of cow having 400 kg body weight. So how much concentrate and how much roughage should be offered in 10 kg, under 10 kg? So further it divided into 10 kg ka 1/3, 10 kg ka 1/3 how much it is 3.3 kg. So 3.33 kg concentrate will be required and roughage 10 kg का 2/3 portion. So 2/3 दो यहाँ पे 213 दिखा रहा है, एक्चुअली ये ऑब्लिक होगा 2/3 होगा। So 2/3 होगा 6.66 kg and dry matter from dry roughage. If green roughage, green fodder is available, then dry matter from dry roughage, it should be 2/3 of that dry roughage portion. That means 6.66 ka 2/3, that is 4.44 kg. Usi tarah se dry matter from green grasses or green roughage. So 6.66 ka 1/3 portion, that is 2.22 kg. So 2.22 kg and 4.44 kg दोनों को जोड़ देंगे तो आएगा 6.66 kg. Accordingly, you can see here that if legume is available, then it is again variation. But the total requirement of the roughage should be 6.66 kg. So accordingly, you can calculate and accordingly you should know how much dry roughage and how much concentrate should be offered to 400 kg body weight crossbred cattle. And how much leguminous fodder and how much green fodder should be offered to 400 kg crossbreed cattle? आप इस टेबल से, आप इस कैलकुलेशन से आप उसको देख सकते हैं और कितना रिक्वायरमेंट होगा उस कैटल का, आप उसको फीड कर सकते हैं, इसमें कोई बड़ी बात नहीं है। सो दिस इज द वे ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द साइंटिफिक फीडिंग और साइंटिफिक राशन। Accordingly, you should know about the how much, this is the dry matter calculation of dry matter requirement. अब dry matter requirement calculation के बाद आता है कि how much DCP and how much TDN will be required. So this is also very much important and you should go through this table, and this table is also available in the books. So you should better to go for to see this table in books. It will be elaborated there. So accordingly, you have to remember some data. What does you remember some DCP requirement and TDN requirement for cattle having 300 kg body weight, 400 kg body weight, buffalo having 500 kg body weight. So accordingly, you should remember these data. You kept in mind these some value, not all, some data which is generally used and generally is being practiced for formulation of a standard ration. So you remember the some DCP value and TDN value accordingly for preparation of scientific ration. So there are some important tips of feeding of dairy animals. So that should be kept in remember always, that green fodder which must be chopped before feeding to the dairy cow for better utilization. Actually, when we feed green fodder in unchopped condition, then there is the loss of gross energy, loss of energy while the animals chew more time. So chewing time will be more when unchopped powder will be given to the animal. So while working on chewing, the animal losses some amount of the energy, and they also pick and choose. They just consume the leafy portion, and hard material or stemmed material should be left. So there is wastage of the green fodder also. So to save the energy loss and to save the green fodder and to save the nutrient losses from the green fodder, we must adopt this technology, chopping or physical method जिसको बोल सकते हैं, physical method से हम उसको chop करेंगे. After chopping, we can offer to the animal for it will always improve the utilization of the nutrient by particular animals. So we must follow the chopping method for feeding the green fodder. And if possible, we can soak the dry roughage also. We can soak the wheat bhusa. We can soak the paddy straw. Chopped paddy straw, we can soak the concentrate mixture in water for few hours, and we can after soaking we can offer to the animals. It will enhance the nutrient availability in the body. So the required concentrate mixture, green fodder and straw, actually we are offering three kind of the feed: concentrate feed, green fodder and straw. It is better to prepare a sani, or it is better to prepare a TMR, total mixed ration. So these three kind of the feed and ingredients be mixed together. Either we offer separately or we can mix together. So it is always better to mix together and feed to the animal, जिसको हम लोग अपने भाषा में बोलते हैं सानी method of the feeding. तो सानी बना के उसको फीड कर देना, उसमें थोड़ा सा मॉइस्चर भी रहता है, थोड़ा वाटर भी मिलाते हैं हल्का, रफेज ले लिए, कंसंट्रेट ले लिए, ग्रीन फॉडर ले लिए, थोड़ा सा वाटर ले लिए, उसको प्रॉपरली मिक्स कर दिया टब में, उसके बाद एनिमल को ऑफर किया. उसी को TMR भी बोल सकते हैं. TMR में एक ग्रीन फॉडर स्ट्रॉ होगा, साथ में इंडिविजुअल कंसंट्रेट मतलब की मेज हो गया, सोयाबीन हो गया, जो भी है इंग्रेडिएंट, उसको मिक्स करते हैं, साथ में मिनरल मिक्सचर एंड विटामिन मिक्सचर, प्रीमिक्सेस जो भी है उसको मिक्स करेंगे, सभी एक साथ मिक्स कर दिया, उसको फिर ऑफर कर दिया, उसको TMR बोलेंगे. तो सानी मेथड हम लोग भी यूज करते हैं, उसको मशीन से भी TMR, आजकल फॉरेन कंट्री में मशीन से TMR बनाता है, तो TMR मशीन इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल. सो TMR feeding or Sani method feeding is always better for production, getting optimum production from the animal and getting optimum utilization of the nutrient by the animals. And total ration, whatever offered daily, that should be divided into at least twice. Or we are also following this condition in farmers. This method is being followed in morning and afternoon. मॉर्निंग में खिलाता है जानवर को और आफ्टरनून में खिलाता है, दो बार खाना देता है. तो इस तरह से वी कैन ऑफर इन डिवाइडेड डोज, टोटल राशन शुड बी ऑफर इन डिवाइडेड डोज टू द एनिमल्स एंड फीड ट्वाइस डेली फॉर बेटर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ द एनिमल्स. वन इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट हियर आई हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डू नॉट फीड द calcium rich feed ingredients, or do not supplement calcium or mineral mixture to the dairy cow before 15 days before parturition. Parturation se do saptah pehle calcium rich feed or mineral mixture supplementation kam kar dena chahiye to maintain the optimum homeostasis condition of the calcium in the body. And if we offer, then they disturb the body calcium homeostasis, and they disturb the whole cycle of the animals. So the animal the hormonal function will also disturb. So we should avoid calcium feeding before 15 days of the parturition. Always provide clean and fresh water. And free choice water should be given to the dairy animals. And water tank should be cemented, and it should be constructed near the animal sheds. And the tank should be painted with the lime to avoid any type of contamination in the water. So water plays very important role in the production and maintenance of the different physiological condition of the animals. So we should take care about that. So this is all about the today class, and